My name is Andrew Ambetsa. I'm a photographer, professional photographer. Basically, I major on portrait photography. I do the photography and I mount photos. Can't say a normal day because a project does not take a day. There's the actual shooting of the photos, there's the pre-shooting of the photos, and then there's the post-shooting of the photos, how to edit the photos and bring out something that will be presentable to the client, looking through the different photos that you shot. So before I go out to shoot photos, I meditate on the kind of scenario. Probably if the client wants me to go somewhere that I've been before, I think through what would give out the best shots and what would be the best product that would come out of those shots, the scenery, all that. I like to do a lot of photography in places that have nature. It brings out something that is authentic and just special. So I visit the place in my mind and picture what we're going to do. I prepare my stuff, I make sure that my battery cells are charged. My camera equipment, everything is in place, and I put them all together so that when I'm going out for that particular event or that shoot, I'm ready for that. From experience, if you don't do that the previous day, you fail to pick some crucial items which you cannot do without when you're doing the shoot. So I have to do preparation in terms of the equipment, and psychologically I make myself ready so that I can go out for the shoot. During the event, there are sometimes when I've planned how I'm going to set the client in terms of where they will stand as they are shooting the photos, but also the creative bit of working with what you have at that particular moment. Really, I would say 20% of it is preparation in mind of what I am going to do, but 80% comes in on that particular time from the experience that I've had before and what I see at that particular time when I'm shooting the photos. After I have done the shooting of the photos, it comes down to the post-production, where I sit down with the photos on my computer and I look at the photos. Do I crop them? Do I add more color? It depends. I don't like doing anything with Photoshop in terms of removing the background and whatever. I like working with the photo the authenticity of that moment, because it captures the essence of what I was doing at that particular time. I would say like 95% of my photos are just the genuine photo, the way it was taken and where it was taken. So it speaks of the mood of what I was taking at that particular time. So doing post-control photography, then giving some samples to the client and then they approve. And basically that's the end of the project. I would like to categorize it in two ways. Fellow photographer in terms of people that I've met and I've shot with them in events, and that is what I do most of the time. Sometimes it's expensive to get a fellow photographer to hire them for an event. So I have mentored and I still continue to mentor a lot of people in photography. So those are the ones that I use in events. Because it's a learning experience for them, and I also don't have to pay over the odds to get them to do that work with me. And also I can be able to direct them. I am the one now who's, they're using my eyes to see the event, so I capture what I require from that, and it's it's me who's taking the photos because I'm directing, I'm telling them the ISO needs to be this much, needs to be this and this, because they are learning from me. So they will take the photos the way I want them to be taken. And a bit of their creativity also would come into play once they have learned the things that I'm teaching them. It depends also from event to event. There are major events where in a wedding where I would require maybe 2 or 3 photographers at the same time because of the different places where we would be and the different equipment that I need. A portrait photography client who is one and the venue and all that, sometimes I just have to do that by myself instead of having all the people to be, because there's really not much. I only have one camera during that time and different lenses. First of all, it stands from your value. What is your value? You have to know your value. There's clients that whom I'd work with, and the size of the project would cost them an arm and a leg, but they can be able to pay that. And there's also clients that the size of the project that they're working on, maybe they have been working on a tight budget. You have to come to a mutual understanding. But I know my value. I've had to turn down some work with somebody thinks they are paying over the odds, but for me, that value, it's not there. It's not achieving what I want to get from the work that I'm doing. And I don't do shoddy work. I give the best as a professional. So I have to turn down that and probably recommend somebody else, because for the input that I will give in, there's a lot of inputs: the camera, the workmanship, the labor, all that post production. And sometimes people think that the value of the money that you're offered is what you will get paid at the end of the day. That's not true, because there's a lot of things. What do you want as an end product? So I'll package the pricing depending on the end product and the amount of time that I spend on it and the creativity that it entails to do that work. So pricing varies from what the client requires and the timing also, the amount of time that I spend on the project. So the pricing will vary. But one thing is for sure, I know my value and I know the work that I do. So I will price myself according to my value and the work that I do. There is some work that I wouldn't think twice about taking because I know that is, I am not at that range. I am on a different range. So once you've valued yourself, you will know how to price yourself. Skill in photography is one thing, but when you're dealing with human beings, especially on the business end, that's where the challenges have really come in. I've had clients whom have taken photos of and they've paid a deposit and they've refused to pay the balance, or they were unable to pay for one reason or another. I've had clients who have paid up money and then not, for some reason, not wanted to pay up the rest of the money, and they have probably tried to get out of the deal that we had together with them. And I've even had clients who have held me by my collar wanting to assault me, and because they didn't want to pay up, so they were really trying to get out of that. It's been an experience, but it has made me wiser. It has made me to know how to deal with clients before. It's the thing about this is that now I know how to deal with a client before the event, because it helps me to gauge what kind of a client this is, and we have an agreement before, and the issue of payment is agreed before, so that it doesn't burn my fingers. Things that I cannot control about how a client will react when it comes the time of payment, I anticipate and I plan accordingly, having in mind the experiences that I've had. There's no shortcut about that. Every photographer will have that kind of experience. So you cannot know who is a good client and who is not a good client. But all the same, you have to deliver value for the work that you're doing, because it's not about punishing the client or anything. It's about projecting yourself in the work that you're doing. Yeah. Learn. Learn your craft. Learn what is your niche, and learn the business bit. Learn your craft. By that I mean that you have to hone your skills continually. You have to learn something new about how to use your camera, how to get the effects that you want. Not just taking the same kind of photo all the time. You have to also become more creative by looking at other people's work and thinking about yours. Having in mind, looking at a variety of things to enhance your creativity. Learning the business bit. Photography by itself, the skill, you can have all the skills, but if you do not know the business part of it, it is not going to turn into something that is worthwhile for you in terms of pocket-wise. Initially, when I was starting out and doing a lot of the mounting of the photos, I would really outsource in terms of somebody to do my graphics for me. But with time, I started learning how to use software for graphics myself, because sometimes the end product of what I got and what I expected was not up to the task. So I started learning how to do it myself so that I can do it the way that I want to do it. So it's good if it's somebody who knows your mind, who knows exactly what you want and who will deliver at the time that you want them to deliver, then it's easy to work with that person. But unfortunately, many people who would do that part of the design part, they're thinking about how much you will pay them rather than the work that they will deliver to you. It's not all of them that are like that, but most of them would think in that manner. So they don't want to deliver to you the exact quality that you want. They want to see how they can do the least for getting the most from you. So I find that if you find somebody who understands your mind, what you appreciate and what you like, and they're able to deliver that, you can be able to work with that such kind of a person easily. Hello Effect Tech, it's a photography company. It's a company that deals a lot with doing event photography and portraits and family birthdays and all that. And it deals also a lot with mentoring upcoming photographers, teaching them to hone their skills and how to use cameras in the correct way. So it's not only a company that does photography, but also looking at the fact that there are other people outside there teaching them how to use a camera in the proper way and how to present products that would be pleasing to the client. So that is what we do at Hello Effect, and I love what I do with the people that I work with. I have a background of being a teacher, so I always love giving information and just facilitating people learning. People who cannot be able to access certain things and learn with them, and access a professional from a different, high-ranking professional. I like working with those kind of people so that I can be able to hone their skills, create interest, people who are just a youth who is out of school, who doesn't have anything to do, just to create a spark for them to see that there's something they can do with themselves. Yeah, that's what we do at Hello Effect, and we love what we do. As in any other field, hard work cannot be substituted. And in this field of photography, especially portrait photography, you have to work hard. And it's not like lifting stones or anything. You have to go to the best website, see how they've taken their photos, go to YouTube, see how to achieve certain kind of portraits, and just constantly refreshing yourself and renewing the skill that you have at the point where you started. And then package yourself. Remember, you are creating a moment for the client. Know how to speak with the client, know how to work with the client. And thirdly, remember that it's a business. You're not in it for charity. Do your best to give competitive prices, but also prices that will not cause you to close business after a while. You have to knuckle down. It's not going to come easy. It's tough work for you to build a rapporteur where you will find people calling you for you to take their photos. That one doesn't come easy. They have to trust you for a period of time. You have to be there. You cannot just work as a photographer for 6 months and then choose to do something else. You have to be in it for the long haul. Whether it is the sun is shining or it's a rainy day, you have to be there. You have to be counted on. When somebody picks up their phone and calls you that they want some work to be done, they will find you there. So it's not an easy road, it's hard work to build your name and to build your brand.